Hello kids, well today we will start lesson number 15, simple future tense. In our previous lessons, that is lesson number 13 and 14, we have studied about simple present tense and simple past tense. Yes, so now today we will study about simple future tense. So children, simple future tense refers to something that is going to be happen in the future. Okay, so anything which will happen in the future, for that we say the sentence is in the simple future tense. Children, we express the simple future tense usually by adding a will before the root verb. Means children, when the root verb is given, simply by adding will before it, we can change the sentence into simple future tense. And sometimes children, shall is used. It's not normally used unless a suggestion is made. Very rarely we use the word shall also when we have to change the sentence into simple future tense. Okay. So, when we have to give any suggestion to any person, at that time we use shall. So, let us see the examples of it to understand it. I shall see you tomorrow. Okay. So, now here root verb is see and shall is added. So, this is the sentence which is there in simple future tense. Shall we dance? Now again you can see dance is the root verb, shall is there. So shall we dance? So it's a simple future tense sentence. Next sentence, you will learn English in 2 years. Now here learn is the root verb, before learn will is added. So this sentence is again in simple future tense. Grandmother will tell us a story. Here tell is the verb and will is the word which we have added to a root word, so it's a simple future tense sentence. Okay children, so the verbs that have been highlighted above show something that is going to happen in the future and is said to be in the future tense. So I think it's very easy, you just have to add will, and sometimes only we will add shall when we will give any suggestion, so to change the sentence into simple future tense. So quickly let us start with the exercise of it to make you understand it clearly. First exercise is there children, filling the blanks with verbs in the simple future tense form. Okay, so root verbs are given in the bracket, so we will use that root verb to change the sentence into simple future tense. So first one you see, Ashish dash home in a while. Root verb is come, so we will write will come. Ashish will come home in a while. Veena dash to you in the evening. So root verb is talk, so we will write will talk. Veena will talk to you in the evening. Next sentence, robots dash the housework in future. Do is the root verb, we will write will do. Next sentence, we dash a nap after lunch. So we will take. Next sentence, dash I dash today leave. So here we will write shall I leave today. Okay, see the next sentence children, Sonal dash in the evening. Root verb is study, so we will write will study. Next sentence, it dash today, it will rain today. Next sentence, we dash a television for Christmas. We will buy a television for the Christmas. So children, as you can see in this exercise, simply by adding will or shall, we can change the sentence into simple future tense. So now let us start with exercise number 2 of this lesson. Write the following sentence in simple future tense. Okay, so see the first sentence, Kiran makes delicious cookies. Now here verb is makes. Okay, so now we have to change this into simple future tense. So we will add will before make. So the sentence will be like this, Kiran will make delicious cookies. Okay children, understood how to do this? Okay, so now let us see the next sentence. The bird is flying. Now here is the verb. So here instead of is, we just have to add will. So we will write, the bird will fly. Flying ka it will become fly because it is the sentence. Here you can see is flying. This is present continuous tense sentence. So when we change this into simple future tense, so instead of is we will write will, and instead of flying we will change into fly. The bird will fly. Like this you have to do. Okay. See the next sentence. Jamil swam in the pond. Now here swam is the verb. Okay. It is in the past form. So we have to change this into future tense. So we will write, Jamil will, instead of swam we will write swim, present form, in the pond. So children, as you can see here we have changed this into simple verb, root verb, that is swim, and before swim we have added will, so it becomes Jamil will swim in the pond. So this sentence we have changed into simple future tense. Okay. See the next sentence, I am mopping the floor. Now here this sentence is in present continuous tense. Okay, so we have to change this am mopping into simple future tense. So we will write, I will mop. Mopping ka it will become mop. I will mop the floor. Next sentence, Nana sleeps in peace. Now here verb is sleeps. So we will change it into future tense by adding will before it. Nana will sleep in peace. Okay. Next sentence, Bhuvan plays tennis after school. Now here plays is a verb, so we have to change it. So we will write, Bhuvan will play tennis after school. Next sentence children, Heman brought apples from the farm. Now here brought is the verb. Okay. It's in the past form. Okay, it's simple past form word. So we have to change this into root verb present form and we have to add will to it. So we will write, Hemant will, brought ka present is bring. Okay, normal root verb is bring. So we will convert this into bring when we have to change it into simple future tense. So Hemant will bring apples from the farm. Okay, see the next one. We pulled the water from the well. Now here pulled is the verb. It is in again past form. So we will change it. So we will write, we will pull the water from the well. Okay, see the last sentence of this exercise children, they are going to school. Now this sentence is in the present continuous tense. So are going is given. So we will change it into future tense by writing they will go. So instead of going, we'll change it into go to school. Okay. So like this, you have to do this exercise. Now let us see what is there in the next page. One more exercise is there, children. That is exercise number 3. Look at the picture and complete the sentences with verbs in future tense. Now again, you have to see the picture and you have to complete this exercise with simple future tense verb. Okay. The child dash a picture. First one is the child dress a picture. Now as you can see in the picture, the child is doing drawing. Okay. So we will write the child will draw a picture. Next sentence, he dash his room. So what you can see, children, in the picture, the boy is cleaning his room, right? So we will write he will clean his room. Now next picture, you can see the boy is singing. So we have to change it into future tense. So we will write Rahul will sing for us. Next sentence, Atif dash our clothes. Now you can see this man, his name is Atif. What he is doing? He is stitching a cloth. Yes. So we have to change this into simple future tense. So we will write Atif will stitch our clothes. Last sentence of this exercise, children. Dona dash a cake. Now as you can see, what Dona is doing, she is baking a cake. Yes, she is going to bake a cake. So we will write Dona will bake a cake. So we completed our exercise number 3 also. Do complete this in your textbook. Thank you.